Hey, Prince Bosco here, another video, and I'm just testing out this PlayStation Share thing, seeing how it works. I'm playing the new Zombies map, Dreisendrach, which takes place just after the Giant, or at least that's what it says. Now, there are a lot of interesting things going on with this map, tons and tons. And I've just been able to play just a little fragment of it all. But yeah, so I'm gonna see how long I can survive and what can I accomplish. Okay, so it seems like the mystery box is this way. So this is interesting. I'm not sure what this is about. It looks like Liquid 115, which if it is, then it's a little interesting. But yeah, it's a little different, but it's a really cool map from what I've played, which is a couple times. This is my fourth time playing the map. It is quite awesome, and I hope to be able to play with Doctor later tonight. If you didn't know, this is February 2nd, the day of its release. And yeah, so I'm just going to play through. Maybe it's going to act like almost like a tutorial. I could try to show you guys some stuff that I know so far. I know pretty much bare minimum, but I do know that to look for where the mystery box is at the beginning, which is quite crucial, is you must look up there. So yeah, it's pretty good. Hopefully this is catching my voice. I have no idea. Like I said, just testing it out. And we'll see what happens. Got the locust, not the best, but I do have it maxed out, so I can make do with it for now. And so step two, after you get yourself preferably, I would say, two weapons. And as you can tell, there's one of the dragons that you have to feed the head for. So I might as well actually just do that right now, or at least do as much as I can. And then, so I'll do that. Probably not going to be able to feed the entire head, but I can certainly try. I would suggest getting a weapon that is effective and one that gets you points. That'll be able to get you pretty far into the game with very little trouble, as long as you know relatively what you're doing, and I don't. So yeah, my first time playing through, I got to around 19, which is my record as of now, unless I manage to beat it within this playthrough, which would be pretty cool. But yeah, the Panzer is the biggest problem. The upgraded Panzer sold that, but you don't know it's from Origins, and it's pretty hard to beat, I'll say that. This weapon, HVK, I would recommend. It's a pretty sturdy gun. Can get you good kills, can get you good points. Locust, not recommended necessarily, although it's probably my second go-to sniper rifle, which isn't saying much. Anyways, so I'll continue feeding this head and feeding the head and getting points until I can move on. So that's definitely recommended. The Wonder Fizz machine is also back, and I fed the head. It's done. So that's one head done. And this is interesting, this recording here.
This is Eagle's Nest, over. Richtofen, is that you? When we didn't hear from you, we feared the worst. Fear not, Dr. Groff. It is me, Edward. Any reports from the Giants?
It's Yeah, so basically, the Eagle's Nest, I forget actually what it is, which... I really wish I could remember, but I'm pretty sure it is either just the main base of Group 935, or it's actually referring to the Giant. I forget, which is very unfortunate, but either way, I'm pretty sure it's one of those two things. Either way, I'm leaning more on the, on being the Darice. So Dr. Groff, if you don't remember, or you don't know, he was originally put on the project of Moon. And obviously in this timeline, it looks like they haven't gone to the Moon, which probably means that Richtofen just wasn't teleported there, or he never used the teleporter in that fashion. So basically Dr. Groff is put in charge of Moon, the Moon base, and yeah, so my vague description. Alright, so I'll show you where you should probably go after you complete some stuff. Basically what you should do is go up these stairs here, because what you want to do is turn on power, which I'm derping. Okay, so no, you're supposed to go over this way. You see that floating stuff, you're going to want to get move that. Just want to get past this.
This is where other Richtofen lived before. Well, before Richtofen put bullet in Richtofen.
And then you want to go up there and go through that door, which costs 1500, which I obviously don't have yet, so I'm going to have to save up for that, which might take a little bit of time. Hopefully not too much time though, so I might as well just stay here. And that's why it's quite crucial to have a gun that can get you points. Because you're gonna need points, for sure. Like almost any other map, you're gonna need points. So, I'm basically gonna try to teach you guys how to survive decently well. It is day one, so there's going to be mysteries that I don't know, and probably most people don't know. I know some of the ins and outs, so I will consider myself experienced, to say the least. And if you're wondering, power is just over here, actually, if you followed how I went. Depending on which way you go, which depends on where the mystery box is, you can either come from that way, which I came from, or you'll come from this way, which is the way I'm going to have to go next, because as you can tell, there is a dragon there. So basically all this guy's going to do, Dr. Groff is going to talk to this Richtofen about various things. And eventually he'll notice on the surveillance that he's working with the enemy, which is Dempsey, Dempsey and Nikolai. And that's going to be, you know, a little weird. I actually think it might be Takeo, because I don't think they trust Japan too much in this timeline. So perhaps referring to Takeo. So anyways, he's just going to talk about that, and she think that Richtofen's betraying him, and he will just say that he won't let him leave this place alive, which I'm not sure what that means, but... Anyways, so you'll eventually get up here. And while up here, make your way over here. There is the rocket shield part right over here, but I'm not sure where the other parts are. I only know where one other one could be, so I'm not all too useful. But yeah, as you can tell, if you come over here, you can see that there's the other head. But you're going to want to get points for it. As you can tell, this room is an important room, just by the music, so you can tell that there's something of great importance in this room. As you can tell, there's the MPD, which can be found in this like temple-ish kind of room.
He seems unaware of current situation.
So yeah, I'm just gonna feed this head, and hopefully we can go without a hitch. That would be very ideal. I don't know what that is. Ah, it's not very useful. Not very useful at all. So, if you've played Black Ops 2, this is good for any all of the maps. This is going to be familiar to you because this is exactly like Mob of the Dead. Because it's just like feeding the three head. You do get a special weapon, and the weapon is pretty powerful. Not super powerful. In fact, I think I like the Hell's Retriever more, unless there's a way to upgrade the weapon or not. But if you saw the trailer for this map, you would have seen the weapon, which is a bow and arrow. So that's pretty nice. Pretty nice. This room is quite good for training. It's probably one of my more recommended training area, actually, because it's very circular and the zombies aren't hard to dodge. Shoot those zombies up a bit, and I've actually never noticed this before. What is this room? Oh.
A tomb for kings. They would be disgusted if they knew what group 935.
I didn't even know that was a way. Actually, no, I think I did. Never mind. This is interesting. Those guys are. I believe they're called Guardians. They're from Shadows of Evil, so that's kind of interesting that they're here. And this is the MPD, which once again is a little interesting. So right now what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to look for Juggernog, which I don't entirely... I do know where it is, I just don't remember exactly how to get there. Quickly, anyways. I know a long way to get there. I'll show you where Juggernog is. Basically, you want to come down here, go up these stairs. You need to have power on. Go around, just past it, actually. It's right there.
It is good job these machines are here. They please Nikolai very much.
That's for the pack-a-punch. As you can tell, these little tiles, if you stand on them for a while, will eventually power on. If you stand on all of these tiles for a little while, it'll do something a little interesting. I didn't stand on it long enough. Ah, jeez. Well, it's hard to when you're being chased by zombies, that's for sure. No easy task. Good, I made a crawler too. And if you go on the last one. And that's also the last head right there. And now, if you try jumping, you'll notice that you have zero gravity. You can run on these walls. And what I'm pretty sure you're trying to do is go on top of these tiles that you see everywhere.